my mic, oh, there we go. Good morning and welcome to worship. Glad that you've chosen to be with us as we gather today. And the gospel will be presented by our children and by the music. So we really appreciate all of those who have had leadership in this process, especially Jill May and all of the team for the education committee. Welcome. If you're a visitor with us, we welcome you. We will be having communion today. We have an open understanding of communion, so you are welcome to come forward and receive the body and blood of Christ and the bread and wine. I think those are the only other, any other announcements we need to make as we come together today? Of course, I always have one more to go after. I don't know why I do that, but anyhow, just a reminder, downstairs there'll be a fellowship and a time to greet and say hello to our youth and children and thank them for all that they've done for our worship today. We'll also be passing out our Christmas baskets today, and so we want to thank the Social Ministry Committee, who all put that together, especially David Stewart and Bernadette Wellman. Bernadette's shaking her head with David. He does a lot of work with this, and we really, really, really appreciate his willingness to do that for all of us here at St. Paul. Anything else? Okay. Seeing none then, we begin with our prayer as we light the candles and prepare for worship. Light how many candles today? How many? One, two, no, three, no, four. Right, yeah, four candles. And remember, we light them what color? Purple. Let's say it all together. Purple, pink, purple, okay? Now the purple candle, or the pink candle last week, is kind of a break from the purple. We just like to do things a little different in the church sometimes, okay? It's a reminder about joy. It's a reminder to celebrate what God is doing every day. So who are we still missing? Oops, before I ask that, where are our wise men? Did you see them? Yeah, what happened? Were they there? Where were they last week? Yeah, they're right there. What's going on? What do you think? Why are they still there? Yeah, Billy. They walked for a long time. Maybe they got caught in a sandstorm. Okay, or what? Or they're tired. Yeah, decided to rest. Maybe they found an oasis. Do you know what an oasis is? An oasis is a place where there's water in the desert, okay? And trees and places to rest, okay? So that might be where they are. So who are we still missing from our manger? We got all our animals, okay? We got our shepherd boy. Who are we missing? We got an angel. Yes, yeah, Mary and Joseph, okay? So I'm gonna read this and then, well let's put our people up first, okay? So how about we let Mary and Joseph put up Mary and Joseph? How's that? That's kind of cool, right? Okay. Do you want to put up the donkey for your brother? Not till later. They come a lot later, but good point. Okay. Thank you. So who's coming on Saturday? Who's coming on Saturday? Yeah, thank you. I know you guys are all excited and nervous probably for the play, right? Jesus is coming on Christmas Eve, okay? Good news, God is filling the hungry with good things. Good news, God is lifting up the lowly. Good news, God is about to do his mightiest work. He will cause righteousness and praise to spring forth from the nations. We light the fourth candle, remembering that God's promised one comes to comfort all who are afflicted and to afflict all who might be too comfortable. So we light the candle. I need four volunteers. Come on up, let's get one. Okay, thank you. Miss Michaela, you want to be number two?
Yeah.
What color? Purple. No, I do purple. Yeah. I know you probably want pink. Let's do the purple, okay? Somebody else? Very good, thank you. One more. You want to light one, Jackson? You got the easy one, right? Okay. Come, Lord Jesus. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And we sing all four verses of hymn 240.
Given to us straight from his love, lest we forgot his foretight for to the great truth brought on that night, his gift for love, for ultimate speed, the gift of salvation to those who believe.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor, David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God, and now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be of me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
A long time ago, a young woman named Mary lived in a village called Nazareth. One day, an angel appeared to her.
"Mary, blessed by God, has given birth to a son. His name is Jesus. I happily serve the Lord, and his will be done."
Mary married a man named named Joseph, who was a carpenter. One day, Joseph had to go to a town called Bethlehem to pay his taxes. Mary went with him on a long, hard journey, even though it was almost time for her to give birth to her baby.
Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration, and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Joseph arrived in Bethlehem. It was crowded, and they looked for a place to stay.
What do you want?
Please, my wife is about to have a baby, and we need a place to stay.
There is no room in the inn, but you can stay in the stable with the animals.
Thank you.
Joseph led Mary to the stable where she gave birth to a baby boy.
His name is Jesus.
Thank you.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. And the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news and great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David, who is the Messiah of the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angel had left them and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told about this child, and all who had heard were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
There were shepherds in a field watching over their sheep during the night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were afraid.
"Go away. We are afraid of you. Do not be afraid. I bring you good news. A child was born today in Bethlehem. Savior is Christ the Lord. You find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger."
The sky filled with angels saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
"Look at the sky, angels. Let's go to Bethlehem and find the baby that the angel told us." "Good idea, let's go."
The shepherds went to Bethlehem to find Mary, Joseph, and the baby Jesus. They worshipped him as he slept.
Thank you.
time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born, King of the Jews? For we observed his star at his rising, and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star would appear. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
And favor with both God and man. He was the Son of God, sent to save all those who believe in
from their sins.
Congregation, please stand for the prayers of the church.
With the psalmist, Heavenly Father, we dare pray. Stir up your might. We even ask to be restored. We want to see your face shine, that we may know that you are our God and we are your people. The celebration of your son's birth on earth is near. Stir up your power and God.
Be born anew in us.
Holy Spirit, even as Paul was set apart for the gospel of God, you can call us also to be your saints. As we proclaim the good news of the resurrection from the dead, remind us that we belong to your Son, Jesus Christ. Stir up your power and come.
Be born anew in us.
The fulfillment of the expectation of this season is upon us. And there will be joy as you remember the struggle of Joseph, the pain of Mary, and the counsel you give us. Do not be afraid. Stir up your power and come.
Be born anew in us.
We remember the sick, the weary, and especially the lonely this evening. Help us say, Emmanuel, God is with us. By our care, our cards, our gifts, and our reunions. Listen as we name those you already know, but which we need to speak. LaDonna, Judy, Al, Helen, Ernie, Miles, John, Betty, Kenny Lee, Jackie, and Charles. Stir up your power and come.
Be born anew in us.
For whom else and what else shall we pray? Stir up your power and come.
Be born anew in us.
All the earth, seas, and heavens are yours, and we pray these prayers because you have promised to listen to us.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Share with one another the sign of God's peace. Please be seated. We have a couple of graduates. We want to recognize Jacob Simpkins and Zoe May. Would you please come forward with your families? We don't always get to recognize our college graduates, and some of them here. Today we've come together to give honor and praise and glory to God. We have also come to sit together to celebrate and honor these graduates and to pray for them in their continued endeavors.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. You want to kind of get a change here? Or pray? O God, look with favor upon Zoe. Keep her eyes ever focused on you. Remind her daily that she is loved and cared for by you. As Zoe takes the next steps in her life, help her to do so with boldness and confidence that comes from being in relationship with you, Lord God. O God, look with favor upon Jacob. Keep his eyes ever focused on you. Remind him daily that he is loved and cared for by you. As Jacob takes the next step in his life, help him to do so with a boldness and confidence that comes from being in relationship with you, Lord God. You people, the people of God, will you support and keep these new graduates in your prayers? Will you pray for them? Will you pray for and offer support to the parents of these graduates? If so, answer together as the church, we will and we ask God's help.
Thank you.
Please. Body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. We pray together, or say together, our first communion canticle.
Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people. A light to reveal you to the nations,
and the glory of your people Israel.
Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace.
Let us pray. Most High God, you have come among us at this table. By the Spirit's power, form us to be bearers of your word, sharing gifts of mercy and grace with all through Christ Jesus, our host and our guest.
Amen.
Please be seated.
If then there is any encouragement in Christ, any consolation from love, any sharing in the Spirit, any compassion and sympathy, make my joy complete. Be of the same minds, having the same love, being in full accord and one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility regard others as better than yourselves. Let each of you look not into your own interests, but to the interests of others. That the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form. He humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name. So that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Down. Christmas, you want me a special scarf. I'm no longer just in Bethlehem. I'm right here where you are. You may not be aware of me, and during the celebrations, you'll have to look beyond the stores and all the decorations. But if you take a moment from your list of things to do, to close your eyes and say a prayer, I'm waiting here for you. You're the one that I want to be with. You're the reason that I came. And you'll find me in the stillness when I whisper your name.
God of hope, fill us with joy and peace in believing, so that we may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit, through Jesus Christ, for whom we wait.
Amen.
We sing joy to the world.
Wise number one was Wyatt Utley. Wise number two, Natalia Michaela Baker. She wanted to do a bow.
Christ is near.
Thanks be to God.